also proposed setting up of agricultural logistics park. Agricultural logistics park would provide end-to-end supply chain solutions with support agencies like weighing, testing. It'll be a one-stop solution for the farmer. He carries his produce to the agricultural logistics park. There it is being, it is weighed, it's standardized, its quality is being determined, cold storage facilities are available there, and from there on, the farmer's responsibility is over, he collects his payment and moves away. This recommendation is being given, keeping in view the e-Chopal initiative, which has done something of this sort in villages, local villages. So what we thought is that we can improve the e-Chopal initiative to all parts of India, take up private players in association with the government by giving them financial incentives and subsidies, and make this possible. Another great thing which we propose is that setting up of innovative cold storage. There is a huge power problem in India due to which it takes lot of food is getting wasted. In villages, there is no electricity. So there is this innovative cold storage which is made up of clay, bamboo, water and straw. It can be used for preserving perishable food for up to 6 months. It costs 5 lakhs for setting up each cold storage. These cold storages can be set up by the government in association with the village farmer trader corporations, which we have already recommended. And they can be used in storing the produce so that it will not be as, these cold storages will not function as well as the big cold storages, but they can obviously help us in reducing the wastage to at least half.
Two more minutes.
Now, the government should tie up with NGOs to promote schemes. There is lot of development in the agriculture world relating to the use of modern agriculture methods. So what the government needs to do, it needs to communicate these methods to the farmers, and what it can do that is with the association with the NGOs. The NGOs, self-help groups, they